Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Divide and Conquer, where we play as every faction's battles in the entire game. And last time, we played as Isengard, and we actually took Edoras. The battle crashed, like, 3/4 way through, but I went back and replayed it, and basically the same thing happened. Yeah, that's the last battle. Most of the battle that was fought was pretty interesting, so if you'd like, you can go back and watch it. I'd recommend it. But now, we've got another battle. We've got this large Haradrim army of almost a full stack going up against this large variant.
We will engage them honorably.
As you can see, it's one of the armies they get when they're when they get the blue wizard script, without the blue wizard for some reason. I don't know where he went. But as you can see, it's in their favor, and for the most part, this army doesn't look very good, except for one unit that we get, the Mumakil. So hopefully we can do some major damage and even defeat this army with that. They've got a lot of good units, mostly units we haven't seen before. And if you haven't played Divide and Conquer, you might have never seen before. So, I'm going to save the battle here. And
we shall all find a way to an honorable victory!
So this is going to be a fun first battle to start off with. We've got a pretty easy army to use. Just taking a drink of my nice warm coffee. Anyway, we've got a pretty easy army to use. It's almost an army that the player seems like they could have made. But,
we have our spears
out in front. And we do actually have a pike. That'll be important to have. Actually, they'll probably be up on this hill. If I know the AI at all. So, let's throw our pikemen there.
Spears of Harad.
Our spears on either side of him.
Spear unit
right there. Throw our archers behind. Got a lot of archers in this army. A lot of archers. We're gonna have our Azurazite boarding pikes on the edges. Ooh, I do actually have spikes I can use, but I don't think I'll be able to use them because we're probably gonna be forced to go to them. Anyway, then we have some leftover tiny little units of infantry. Alright, we've got a Black Snake Guard. These are some pretty good cavalry. Look at their face masks. That's pretty cool. And then we've got our Oliphants. Our Mumakil. I don't know where Oliphants came from. We've got our Mumakil. They're going to wreck their army.
Haradian archers.
Missiles. Alright, we are ready to go. And as I said, they started their army up on the top of the hill. So let's get our units up there. And try to sit more on the base of the hill because we don't want to be fighting up the slope. That would suck. Especially, they've got really good infantry. Throw our general around over there. Mumakil. Put right there. That's about
his of Harad.
Alright, yeah, you can afford to wait for very long. Oh, damn. Okay, yeah. I think we're gonna have to charge up our units, considering how much that artillery is going to be. Their cavalry, they just have so much of it where we're not going to be able to flank them. Oh, they're charging us with their chariots. Killed our moon kill already. We're just going to send them straight towards the...
The sun that shines on our disgrace. We must turn the wind of battle, or we will taste ashes instead of victory.
The problem is our archers aren't going to be able to do squat because they're way superior. Their archers are covered.
Curse the sun that shines on our disgrace! We must turn the wind of battle, or we will taste ashes instead of victory!
What looks like most of their artillery, though. They might end up merging.
Only half our force remains!
I don't want to throw away. Kill those wind riders and we'll start.
Archers.
We also killed their chariots. Those beastmasters are really good against Captain.
Horsemen of Harad.
Have them withdraw. Don't want their faction leader dying for no reason. No battle. Other units are really good. Like me, both of us.
Curse the sun that shines on our disgrace! We must turn the wind of battle, or we will taste ashes instead of victory! Archers.
Luckily, looks like.
Bodyguard.
These guys started shooting them in the back. Oh, yeah, our generals left. Now they're.
The sun that shines on our disgrace. We must turn the wind of battle, or we will taste ashes instead of victory.
Out a couple of pretty good units.
And defeat have come to sup at our table. Let us pray they do not visit again for some time.
All right, they lost about 40% of their army. Who got the most kills? Mumakil, I would bet. Yep, 170. That's not a very good number for the Mumakil. They had their archers destroying them, though. Those crossbowmen will shred Mumakil. But that's the Haradrim army defeated. At least their generals survived. We got him out of there before he could get killed. Because the amount of cavalry they had left could have
easily overwhelmed him. We could lay a trap here.
Overwhelmed him. Will.
Yes! We will redeem ourselves! Regroup!
Alright. Everyone's back in here. Yeah, he got slightly, a slight debuff because he ran, but what's to be expected?
How may I serve?
Anyway, guys, I looked at. Yeah, that's the last of the units before the turn ends that we're able to fight. We don't fight these battles until turn 90, because we'd mess up some Mordor scripts if we took control of Mordor, and we don't want to fight as Gondor either, because that would give Mordor a disadvantage if they only had a player fighting as Gondor. But anyway, I'm going to. This is what I usually do. In order to use this, you have to. But anyway, in order to use that, you have to have a mod that unlocks that command, since usually it's locked in the base game. And you also have to know the faction keys, I can't remember the word, but which faction goes to which. So like Gondor is Milan, I believe, Rohan, I think, might be Sicily, and then like Mordor is England, Isengard is France, so you just gotta know all that. There's places you can find it. But anyway, guys, I am going to continue looking for a battle, so I'll see you guys in a second. Hello, everyone. I am back, and I've got the biggest battle probably so far of the series ready for us. We've got two armies of Dol Guldur, one led by the Nazgul. About 6,000 men in total, almost, fighting against 3,000 Valesmen, with many different family members among them and lots of experience. So this is going to be a really interesting battle. This is going to go into the histories of Middle Earth for sure. And the result of this battle will basically decide whose city this will end up being. So as you can see, it's right on the border of Dol Guldur, which makes sense for why they would send such a large host to the city of Valesmen, where they are holding out strong. So let's see if they can continue. Finally, we're starting to get some really big battles going between the forces of good and evil in Middle Earth. Oh, I almost forgot to set my alarm. Reset it.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way.
I'm looking for battles.
Let's pray it remains as such.
On my orders!
Even though we're not fighting as Mordor right now, you'll still get to see one of the Nazgul right there. And then some Temple Wards, also a Mordor unit. And then this unit right here is actually the Castilians. It's basically armor. It's enchanted. There's no one in that, but that's the only unit in this army that you haven't seen before. So there's more units in the other army that's going to be controlled by the AI, though. So I'll have to show you those once they come in. It's actually good that this is a really foresty battle too, because our goblins do much better in the forest. So this really bad trash unit that we'll have will actually become still trash, but not as trashy. Make sure we keep them in the forest.
Slash and burn, slash and burn.
There we go.
Units, assemble
the men. Got about both our flanks. I'm gonna keep our Urks in the back. I'm gonna get to use the Nazgul scream in this battle too. That'll be fun.
Slash.
Keep them back here.
What are you waiting for?
It's go time!
We've got some javelin now. I'll probably keep them behind the line. I'll have them run forward when we're about to charge. We're gonna charge them, I think, in this battle. Oh, we actually have two. So you guys back here, I'll put them both close to the flanks. Put you right there.
Be ready.
The Mistwood Uruks will go around here. You guys will go over here. Got a ballista. And our wargs. Wargs are better in the open, I believe. So we'll throw them over here. There we go. Let's start this battle. Oh shoot, you know what? I must have accidentally clicked control the AI. I don't want to do that. I want this whole army to be controlled by the AI. So I'm actually going to cancel. I saved right before the battle, so everything will be okay. I'll get the battle up and ready for when we have all of these guys ready to be controlled by the AI. So I will be right back. All right, everyone, we are back, and I've got everything set up, and the AI will come under its own control. So let's get going. I don't know how well our ballista is going to do in the forest here, but goblins in the forest. Our other units can start to come out. There we go.
No mercy.
Attacking us. All right, you ready?
They've got some good archers, it seems.
Come on! Pay
attention! Advance! Be ready!
It's go time!
Make them pay!
Sorry if I go quiet for a bit. This episode is a very large battle, so probably gonna need to concentrate a bit. Got some riders. We could probably take these guys out with our wargs. And they are on that side. While everyone's marching, I'm going to show you some of the units you haven't seen yet. I think we've seen these. No, we've seen those guys. So all the goblins. We've seen trolls. Those are the Uruks. Lots of Uruks in this army. More Castilians. Maulers. We've seen those. Oh, here they are. Some more Castilians. They've got giant spiders. Look at these things. They can only recruit these after all of the spiders in Mirkwood have been defeated. pretty interesting unit. Oh yeah, here's the spider hunters. These are the smaller versions. Still marching away. They are. Keep. We don't want those guys going down the slope. Left our works behind by accident. Looks like they're about to charge us. Stop. When your men stop, they brace with them. Alright, everyone, you run now.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Large battles going on over here. There's the noise.
The wolves are hungry.
All right, turn the thing back on. These guys closer to our front line.
Be ready. Get ready for fighting.
Them to throw. Oh look, there's the oh gosh, there's a new three giant spiders remaining.
Only half the enemy force remains!
are... Oh, here's their skin changers. Let's send our wargs over and see if we can help. What do they got? Castilians, you guys go after those skin changers. Looks like our AI down here is doing decently. I think this battle is pretty much wrapped up. We've lost about 50% of our men.
Those are hungry.
Oh shoot! No, get out, orcs. We don't want to fight their skin changers.
Captured the enemy's general! That'll teach the cowardly dog to turn tail and run!
scoop up as many as we can so their city will fall. Lost a good... Well, we didn't even lose quite 50% of our army. Get all of them if we want to make sure that their general is truly dead. Oh, there's the last one. Awesome. Look at this. They killed about 2,000 of us, and we killed about 2,500 of them. Maybe 2,800. No, probably like 2,500. Who of ours got the most kills? The Orc Hunters did pretty good. Honestly, yeah, it was probably them. Good for them. Alright. That's the battle. That was an entertaining one. Big, big battles. You gotta love the feel of huge battles in Total War. Like, with two armies on either side, and you throw one army to the AI. Oh, it makes it so cool. Oh, I would say take it.
No sleeping here. Attack. We've destroyed the enemy.
Another advance team. Well, that was Dogaldor's turn, and that was a fun battle. Look at this.
No sleeping here!
It's pretty wrecked. This one lost a lot of units too, to be honest. But it's alright. They're Dogaldor, so they pump units out pretty much just as fast as Mordor, probably. But anyway, I will... how much time we've got left? About 20 minutes. So we've got about time for probably one more battle. So I'm going to find that one more battle, and I'll be right back. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the last battle of the episode, where we will be playing as the Dunedain trying to hold this city against Agmar. And the Dunedain are seriously faltering. They've lost their capital, Ost-Sol. They are pretty much on the brink of destruction. There's a huge goblin army here, but they must have been pushed back. But over here, you've got large army near Deadman's Dyke, enemy army, and Annúminas would just be next. So we need to hold as much as we can for as long as we can whenever we're fighting as them. So let's get in here. We've got a unit of Witch Knights, and that's it. Large army in here. The balance bar says it's even strength, though. So let's see.
If we bring the battle to the enemy.
They've got a catapult, so we're probably going to hold up the hill. The towers wouldn't really do much anyway, since they're not the good type of towers.
Units, await my orders.
So, there aren't even any towers in here in the first place. So, in that case, we'll probably hold right here.
Forward.
hold these guys back here, just in case they try to flank us. These are our Breland militia. Anyway, here's our Sunidinian. Catapults. But I don't really feel like sacrificing anyone to destroy those. What exactly are they doing? There's a timer, so we could win on time. Oh, that would be awesome. Won't have to worry about these destroying my formations. Doesn't seem like they will.
With great speed!
Okay, there's a very real chance we'll be able to hold them off as long as we need to with everything they just did.
Archers.
Now, I don't want us to use all of our ammo. They're gonna break in no matter what we do. Our local militia are very tired after doing that.
Militia!
Keep them out there just in case they try to come back.
The enemy are battering down the gates!
Yes, so we know that. Luckily, our archers and with our archers. So these pikemen will be a major. Those will be a major unit. We'll try to kill with our archers, even though I think they'll just pull out their swords when they're fighting. And other than these witch knights and these guardians of Carnivium, I think is what they're called, there's not really any units I'm scared of.
his ram has breached the gates.
All right. They are in the city. Try to get these guys up here.
The walls are no longer ours. The enemy have taken them.
You guys actually run. These guys might be going for you.
We're under attack!
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Attack! halfway through the tour.
The battle is very much in our favor.
Now
victory will be
now
ours.
That they're fighting our good warriors. Fresh warriors.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men. Continue like this, we will smash the enemy. Is very much in our favor. Victory will be ours.
Thank you. this is how bad it is to make your units exhausted. Like, now that we're...
Hey! Units, sally forth!
We've gone through units the entire battle, and they still haven't even moved up to very tired. And once they're very tired, when they're very tired and tired and wounded and all that, they go up and down at the same rate-ish. But once they hit exhausted, it's very difficult.
This is a clear victory!
It takes a very long time. Healed some of our casualties, that's good. So we keep the Dunedain alive another day. Good to know. Well, guys, with that, that will be the end of the episode. It's a nice, big, long episode for you guys, filled with a couple pretty large battles and a couple pretty important battles as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed the... We'll definitely execute the game. Hope you guys enjoyed the
episode. We must make a stand. We are besieged.
Oh, Deadman's Dyke is besieged now. Hope you guys enjoyed the rest of the episode, and let's see what's happened. Just more allies. And I'm going to switch over to Papal States. And perfect. We will see what happens in the next episode. So, lots going on throughout Middle Earth. Factions are expanding. Some factions are falling. Things are getting very exciting. I'll show you around a little bit. So again, Edoras has fallen. Looks like there's a small force of Rohirrim outside, ready to try and maybe take it. We've got this huge Lorien army. Maybe, ooh, actually, this could be a battle. This will be a battle next turn. Got that going on. The goblins have overrun a ton of the forces of good up in this area. Even up here, Agmar is ready to push them back. It's going to be a tough battle. Tough battle for both good and evil, because good is definitely winning up in... Well, not definitely. It's still about a 50-50 up here. Because the dwarves are still strong. And Enidwaith is fighting on the side of good. Oh, no, Enidwaith is fighting on both sides. And against both sides, I guess. But over here, we've got Dorwinian... the dwarves and Dale all doing them really well. They've almost pushed the Easterlings back. And we've got, what are they called? The Variags of Khand doing really well down here. They're pushing the Haradrim back pretty well. And both these two factions are at war, Harad and Ar-Ardenium. Gondor still hasn't fallen, too. Good for them. Oh, dang. Look at that. The Variags have pushed all the way up and are going to potentially help out Gondor up here. That's impressive. And up here, we've got Dolgaldor's pushing back the Valesmen. Ooh, looks like they spawned a big army because they're down to 3 settlements. But that's my alarm. But overall, it's pretty close. Pretty close here in Middle Earth. But again, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.